Yes, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the program today. Thank you guys very much for joining. We're getting this party started. Yes, we are getting this party started. Ah, happy Tuesday. How's everybody doing?
Doing all right.
The diva has arrived. How dare you? How dare you? I mean, I do. I really should add a laugh track. That is a thing, huh? Should do that. Maybe we'll add some things to the soundboard today. A fart track? No, thank you. No, thank you. I don't think I'll do that. Yeah, I a laugh track.
What else can we do?
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, the little whistle thing. Add something from Roger. I don't know if I can, if I should. I feel like the Roger thing, I'm gonna get like in trouble for samples or whatever. Rickroll, a screaming goat, burps.
No,
guys, settle down. You guys are too crazy. A cough track, a sniff track. DC or Marvel? Wait, why are we asking me DC or Marvel? Is it because of the Spider-Man trailer? Hey, does anybody know? Here's a question for you guys. Does anybody know if the trailer that leaked yesterday is the same as the trailer that they put out officially yesterday? Because I feel like what happened, here's my guess at what happened, is they had a trailer they were working on and they weren't going to release, and then one leaked, and then they were like, oh shit, like everyone's just so excited, like let's capitalize the excitement, and then they put it out. It was the same? It's the same. Okay. Were they planning to put it out, and it just, they said it was a leak, or what? What is it? I'm waiting for the lag of the... Between... Yes. You know what I'm saying? Doctor Strange supremacy. I was really not sure about Doctor Strange when I first saw the trailer for the movie. And I saw the movie and I really liked it. I like Doctor Strange. I love Spider-Man. I love Marvel. We're watching, we're actually re-watching a bunch of stuff because I've got kids and they haven't seen a bunch of the Marvel movies. So we're like, we're going through and watching those. Excuse me. Oof. Bunch of stuff I have not seen. So I haven't gotten through all of Loki. I haven't gotten through all of Falcon Winter Soldier. We did watch WandaVision. Did see Black Widow. What else? I don't know if I have a favorite character. I don't know. What If? I didn't see What If. No, I haven't seen that yet. We've been spending so much time watching. I don't watch a lot of TV as it is. And then when we are watching a movie or something, we've been watching the old movies. Yeah. I did see Black Widow. I liked it. It was like a James Bond movie. It's a Bond movie. That's what kind of movie that is. We watched Spider-Man Homecoming, and it was fun explaining to the kids that Michael Keaton was the one of the best Batmans. I think he might be my favorite Batman. Michael Keaton was the dude. Jack Nicholson is the Joker. It wasn't an awesome movie, but they were great. It was a good movie, but they were awesome. Is Ant-Man my favorite? No. But I don't hate Ant-Man. He'll be back as Batman? Is that real? Well, that's cool. Favorite Spider-Man? Tom Holland by a long shot. By a lot. To me, there's almost no other Spider-Man. Hot take? I don't know. What do you want? What do you want from me? Tom Holland supremacy. Yeah. What do you want? What do you want from me? The moment it was almost like let me think what it was like. It was like when they hit Mark Ruffalo as the Sayanoe rating. What's up, guys? We're just talking about Marvel movies, Marvel shows and characters. Yeah, when they cast Tom Holland as Spider-Man, it was like when they hit Mark Ruffalo with the Hulk. It's like, oh, that's finally the Hulk. You finally did it. There it is. That's my take. That's my opinion. Today, we are going to... I was thinking we'd make something out of, like, we'll start a track with stuff in the room. I mean, I'll try not to be too silly with it, but, like, I realize I have a couple random things in here that I haven't fully, like, explored. I haven't explored studio space. Like, this thing... This is called this is made by Moon Armada. It's got all these like carved textures on it. And then it's got like microphones inside and a little jack here to plug it into stuff. Yeah. And we can start with that. Let's look around. Let's see what else I got in here that I can work with. I don't know what else, what other kind of stuff. Let's see. We got the little Mega Man thing. We got these little guys. We got the Boxo Percussion. The Boxo Percussion. I got the, where's the little, we got our favorite thing. I haven't brought this out in a while. Make something with this? What if I can make something cool with this? I could maybe make something interesting out of that. I don't know. Got some little drums and things. All right. Let's try, here, I'm going to just pause this nonsense, and we'll try some things. I wonder if you know what would be cool is to try and take this awful thing. I mean, it's fun. This is fun, but it's not like, it sounds like a what do you call it? Why am I forgetting the word for the accordion? Is that the word? Why am I forgetting that word? I don't know. I feel like a little bit goofy. So let's try and make it not goofy. I wonder if we can make it cool. What interesting things can this do that a normal keyboard can't do? I mean, I can bring it to and from the mic, like, so that's a thing. I could do that.
Hold on, let me just see if I... What happens if we do that?
Okay, check this out. So, if I... Oh, oops, wrong button, my bad. If I do that and it's... Okay, it's got like a little, there's like a little room sound at the end of it, which is kind of cool. And then there's this, so I can just do like this. Okay. And then what happens if I start messing with the pitch? Interesting. Texturize? Whoa. That's cool. Let's start with that. I'm gonna do... consolidate it, and then I'm gonna make a new MIDI track, and then I'm gonna put this on the MIDI track, and then we'll do this. Interesting. Kind of cool. Let's bring this like this a little bit here. Okay, what's the tempo that I was kind of playing just now? Let's find out. Not that. Record that just now? I did. Good. All right, so gonna quantize it, gonna remove these guys, grab all of these, make them like this, and wow, the delete button key doesn't really want to work. I bet you we can make it even cooler. Hang on. Space modulator? Let's try that. Too brittle, too high. Okay, I'm turning it down a little bit. All right, so that was our, what's this thing called? Melodica? Harmonia? What's it called? I don't know the name of the thing. Viking? Melodica. This is going to be my, okay, Melodica sample. harmonica? Accordion? Accordion? Melodica? Anyway. All right, so we got that. That's interesting. A little chill. I don't know if I want to go that chill today, but we'll find out. I wonder if we could make like a bass tone from this. Oh, hang on a second. I gotta save. You're right. You are right, W.R. Mello. You are correct. I should save. Yeah, I need to make a bass sound, but I want to make it out of something interesting. I don't want to make it out of like... I don't want to just like... play bass. Random stuff in the room, I guess. All right, we'll call this one, we'll just call this session random stuff in the room. Yeah, like I wonder if I can turn that into like an 808 or something. Want to find out? Let's see if it'll work. I don't know. Two of those and then see if they'll sound good if you pitch them way down. So I'll put it in re-pitch mode so that it kind of retains like the integrity of the sound. And then re-pitch. What am I selecting? No, it's not doing it. That's weird. Usually it just goes down. What the hell? Okay, we'll turn it like that. It's very low. It's kind of working. Okay, that works. That one like distorted. That one's cleaner. I'm gonna use that one. Maybe that tap at the top of it is too much. Maybe like if I cut that off, it'll be better. Or some of it. Let's find out. There. I like that. Okay, so we'll call that our drum 808. And again, I think what I'm going to do is like, we'll, hold on. Ooh, it gets all hissy at the end of it there. I'm going to do this. It's probably better. Control J. Sorry, I need to do quick keys. Not all right. We're not pitched. It's one thing that's going on right now is that we're not like I haven't tuned these to the pitch of anything. So that's definitely not ideal. What you want to do with an 808 is make sure that it's monophonic. Right here, voices, switch it to one. I think I'm going to put a little bit of, I could put decapitator on it. I could put a little just Ableton saturation. Let's try the Ableton saturation real quick. Let's try that. And then, I mean, Interesting. Okay. That could work. What else? What else we have in the room here? What other kind of stuff? What makes a tone?
Is this?
A little bit. It's a little bit of a... Oh! That does. Oh, I'm recording on MIDI instead of audio. Let's try this again. Okay. Those are some interesting little bits. I liked all three of those. Wonder if I take these and do... So they're a little like... Let me turn the metronome off. Like they're a little sharp and tight, and I kind of want them to have a little more like meat to them, a little more body. We can do a lot with this type of a sound though. Like if I went just really nuts and went to like the, you guys are gonna be like, oh my God. So there's that kind of vibe. And then I could also go like, we could go like, guitar rig, maybe. Let's see what happens there. And this is just running it through a whole, like, this is made for, obviously, for guitars and, like, has, like, racks and racks of, like, basically plug-in chains. Sounds like a bird. Okay. Weird. What happens if we just like loop that? Just curious. Can you believe this is the like thing we just, the noise we just played with? Super weird. Whoa! Also too loud. Wait, what is doing that? The flare? Is it the flare? It is. Okay, wait, we just found something. If I get rid of this, let's just use the flare on its own. Okay, hang on a second here. How did we do the... Is it this? How did we change to a noise? A key. Oh, here we go. Wow, okay. Thank you. Dude, you guys. Wow, okay. Huh. Okay, let me see if this mixes with any of this. If I might need to do, I'll need to change the key, but. Oh, I don't know what key we're in because we never got like a proper. Like a VST that actually has a note. We're just using MIDI instruments, using the stuff that I recorded, which doesn't have like a, it's not even necessarily in tune. So let's find something that is. All right, maybe, I don't know, pad. Nope. Maybe. Kind of Juno-ish fun. Okay, so here's like a middle C. So let's. One, two, three, four. Pitch it up four. One, two, three, four. Oops, other way. It's also, I think I'm gonna have to like auto-tune this thing just to see. Here, let's just test it with an auto-tune and see how far out it is. What? There we go. So you can actually tune it like this. Now we're in tune. Ta-da! You can use auto-tune as a tuner. Did you know that? Oh, I probably shouldn't have gotten rid of that because I now need to take this and put it on the melodica. I think I'm gonna put it before the reverbs and stuff though, so. And let's tune this down. All right, cool. That should be right. Okay, so I think we were off by about six semitones. One, two, three, four, five, six. So we are in G sharp. Should we just go down one more and go into G? It'd probably be easier for me to like play too. G. Oh, now we're in G. Interesting. Okay, we've got noises, we've got sounds. Mm-hmm. Okay. We've got some good sounds. This VST, this keyboard is called Super 8. What do we want now? Should get like a little like... What is this? What is this? What is this? Oh, this little stick came out. Is there a stick in here for this thing? It's one of those, these, what are these called? The Karate Kid thing. Indeed. But I do have this. Yeah, how about that? We use it like that. I don't know. Let's see. Yeah. Okay, I didn't record any of that. My bad. Hold on. Wasn't worth recording anyway. We'll call this one Daniel San. Oh, it's got a little shake in it. I missed that last hit, but that might have been actually cool. Pitched it up. Okay, it's in tune. Thank you.
Should we make it less sloppy? What's happened to me? Go. Triplet 16ths. We go like 50% less sloppy. Better or worse? Too not sloppy? Better. All right. That's the 808, the drum sounding. Okay. He's vibing out right now.
Hydrate, trail mix.
That's a guitar cable. Thank you.
Yeah. Oh, I liked that weirdness. Too aggressive for this, but I like it. That's great. You know what's great? It's that I can talk into this. This is fun. I'm not sure we were like making something that's listenable. But it's fun. Need more sounds?
Nice. Nice.
Almost fell over. Slipped. Ha ha ha. That was not on purpose. Can you imagine if I just fucking ate it just now?
Thank you.
Yeah, so that was fun. Add a little glue to kind of background here. Turn down a little bit. Out of tune. I feel like it's a nice chill track. I'm kind of like wishing it was not so chill, but it's nice. You like it? You guys always like to chill. You want every track to be a chill track. I'm in drop D on this thing. That's weird. I didn't realize that. You know what that is? What is that song? That song. What is that fucking? It is Edie Brickell. Ever heard that? No. Oh, so much better than the way I was playing it. I'm a So, if it just got very aggressive right there, that'd probably be bad. I shouldn't do that. Chill this thing out. Dude, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. There it is. Yeah, we're just chilling. I feel like I rushed it that time. that. Let me just listen to it and see if it's any good. It's very, very chill. From the top, just listen to it.
Chilled the fuck out today, guys. Just very relaxed. Very chill today.
I feel like we should just take the whole thing and just like... think we've got it. Think we've got our track for the day. Right? We've done it. I think we've hit the end of the road for this one. A couple shouts. Tulip Mania resubbed. Fran Kids resubbed. Surfing the Darkness with Prime.
Swore it.
Kana Kippers. Prime.
Swore it.
Kozak. Markville 123. D Stank gifted 5. Mazda did 999. Resub. Terramath Prime.
Swore it.
Snug Socks with Prime.
Swore it.
Nighthawk Nina. Celia France. Axinus. Bozer T.
Swore it.
X of N. Yasmin F93 gifted. GM Baker with Prime.
Swore it.
Char 112. 1112. Kemi W. Amber Grindstaff gifted.
Nice.
Keith V. AS with Prime.
Swore it.
LP Buckeye gifted.
Nice.
5 subs. Stephanie Diaz resubbed. John's vibing today with Prime.
Swore it.
Sam Ronson. Thank you, Sam. Bad Cupcake 101 resub. Rude Buo 169. L. J. Len was here. Exus Steel with Prime.
Swore it.
Fubar Mod 27. 7. 20. 77. Pirate Shinoda gifted. STVMRI. Saint Vimri. Ice General resub. Thank you guys very much. Jam, got a little chill. What do we got in terms of questions here? Let's take a look. I should shout out. Oh, before we do a shout, let me just say this. With the bowl, we had a bunch of redemptions last week when we did the bowl of Destiny. And I didn't announce the new Bowl of Destiny redemption. So here's what we got. We got Sicariel wants an LP style atmospheric track. Lincoln Bird 84 wants a New Jack Swing style track. It's very specific. Hez Helps wants something Madonna inspired. Yas O, retro synth wave. Black Phil wants something in the style of Volbeat. And Zmasklowski wants a post-rock style track. Guitar, bass, and drums only. Guitar, bass, drums only. I may have to put that to the side because it doesn't mix with any of the rest of these. Does Volbeat only have guitar, bass, and drums? Because I'm looking at some of these other ones here. We got Coco Blue Games with the Tame Impala style, which we've mixed. We're going to mix with John Bellion, Living Things in One More Light, and a tribute to an Aaliyah song. And Probabilistic with Blue Monday.
And
MA9K with Mass Effect OST. All right, so I think we're going to put LP atmospheric style with retro synth wave. And I wonder if I can mix that with Madonna or New Jack Swing. By the way, New Jack Swing, hold on. There was a song called New Jack Swing. And it was like a, it's like a 80s, late 80s, like swingy dance kind of song. Who is that? Teddy Riley? Yeah, Teddy Riley. I didn't know Rump Shaker was technically a New Jack Swing song, apparently. That's what it says on the Wikipedia's. That might be hard to do with retro synth wave and LP style atmospheric. Let's put the Madonna one with those. Let's do that. Because if post rock doesn't have synths, then I can't mix that with any of these. Blue Monday, Mass Effect. I'm gonna put the post rock one with Blue Monday and Mass Effect OST. I think we can do those together. What if we did Volbeat mixed with New Jack Swing? That's a good start. That's fun. Really weird. That's going to be a strange one. Should I try that tomorrow or Thursday? Am I going to be on Thursday? Where's my phone? Let me just check. Yeah, it looks Thursday. Oh, I'm not going to be on Thursday. Okay, so am I going to be on Friday? I'm going to be on Friday. So it looks like Friday I'll be on. I can't be on tomorrow. Yeah, I can't move Thursday to Friday. So I'll just be on Friday. Should we try this New Jack Swing Volbeat mashup? That's so random. I love how weird that is. All right, we'll come back to that on Friday. That's going to be bananas. It's going to be so weird. Question or two. Let's do this. We'll do a question or two from the Shinoda Bucks Redemptions. What do we have with the questions? Carrie Laya wants to know, since we Linkin Park guys dyed and cut each other's hair back in the day, are we allowed to say Linkin Park had beauty nights? Asking for science. I mean, call it what you want to call it, but we were on the move. We were on tour, and we weren't in a place for very long, and I wasn't about, like, it wasn't as easy then to, like, just find a good barber. Like, now, I mean, there wasn't a Yelp back then, so you couldn't just, like, look it up and be like, this is gonna work. Like, you just have to find some random barber shop, and I wasn't about to do that in, like, I don't know where we were, like, some random place in, like, Minnesota, or in worse, in, like, Europe somewhere, where I, like, didn't even speak the language. I'm trying to explain to them, like, whatever. So we cut and dyed our own hair. I did my own, and then I cut Dave's and Chester's once in a while, and I did Joe's more often. Because our hair is similar. Like, we both have Asian hair, so, like, we could trust each other to cut each other's hair. And then half the time he'd do mine, and half the time I'd just cut it myself. I definitely, bleached and dyed it myself back when I had, like, colored hair. Call it what you want, beauty nights. Jackaz LP wants to know, do I believe in the paranormal? That was all for today. I'm going to come back for the next 800 points. Paranormal, I guess. I'm not like a super duper believer in all that stuff. It's kind of like, I'm kind of like a, that's my answer. Everything today, everybody wants to be, like, very binary with things, like, questions like that, especially on, like, social media. They want you to be, like, yes or no. And I'm kind of like, I don't know. Do you know what I'm saying? Where are the crystals? I have a crystal. It's over there. I got it on a family trip. See it next to the incense, next to David. Yeah. Don't cut my hair. It's getting really shaggy, though. It really is getting pretty big. I don't know. I might need to like just give it a trim. That's what I'm saying about the crystals too. I'm not like, I don't like believe in it, but I don't like not. It's not like, oh, well, they're just like, here's the thing. Let's swap the two real quick. Let's compare the two. Which of the two on a scale of, I shouldn't say on a scale of 1 to 10, because I don't really know what I would put it, where I would put it. What do I believe more, ghosts or crystals? I probably am more inclined to believe in the paranormal than crystals. Crystals are like very low on my feeling about the crystal thing is like, why not? Like, who cares? Am I gonna spend $1,000 on a crystal? No. Am I gonna spend $5 on one because it was like I saw it on a trip and it was funny and we were in the crystal shop and like, why not? Sure. It also is like a keepsake. It reminds me of the trip. So there's like no harm in it. It was like $7 or something. $5? $7? Like, man. Aliens or ghosts? Aliens. 100 times. Like so many times more. I'm not going to make a song called Crystals, no. No. Yeah, the song Ghosts was just about a bunch of people I know telling me ghosts, like, telling me their, like, experiences, like, oh, I had this weird experience, or I had this weird, basically, ghost story. And I was like, again, I was like, wow, like, that's crazy. It's not sass. That's literally my feeling. It's like, wow, okay, crazy. That's crazy. Coincidence? Ghosts? Like, I don't know. I don't really have any, like, skin in the game. I'm not invested. Like, nothing is hinging on getting a correct answer to that question. And you've heard my one... I've had like one real, maybe one or two, the real ghost stories that I personally experienced when I was like, oh, that was super weird. That was very weird. Do I believe we're in a simulation? I don't actually believe we're in a simulation, no. That's not in my worldview. But I'm not, if somebody is like super convinced that we are, I don't think they're nuts. Well, they can be nuts and believe that. That's different. But the fact that they might believe that doesn't mean they're nuts to me. I believe in Boris. Yes, I believe in Boris. Oh, so last thing before I go, you guys know I put up a song on Async Music, an NFT song. Let me clarify this by saying, just a reminder, I'm not doing like, just like in the beginning when I got into like NFTs, I was just experimenting and putting a couple things out there to see how, what it's about and kind of like get to know the technology and the culture and see what it is. And then after a while, I kind of pulled back on it because I was like, it's getting too hectic. Like, there's too many people rushing in to just like make a quick buck. And I actually think there's something really dope about the technology and the culture of it. And you guys know all that stuff. So I don't do a ton in the space, but I do stuff in the space and I love it. I think it's great. Async art, async.art, is doing a thing, has done a few different products that I think are really cool. I did one, I called it Deca Sentry. It is a song in layers, and it currently looks like this. But the thing is that it's all these layers here. So there was different layered stems, like the background, the body, the head, and the little item in front of him. And it came with each of those things, like changes when you change those, it changes the sound of the song. Okay, so just to be clear, right now, this combination, stem mix 2, 2, 1, 1, meaning like each of these has a number from 1 to 4, I think. So it's, they're changing, right? The owner who was me and is now not me. When you change these, it changes the sound. So the current sound of this track is this. So as you see over here on the left now, this used to say Mike Shinoda. Now this says Matt. This, I woke up this morning and Matt had bought all the layers to this NFT. Just so you guys understand, Matt, I woke up this morning and in my, basically I got a notification saying Matt has bought all the layers and the multi-tracks file, like the, what do they call it on here? They call it the master. Matt bought all of them. And I found, like I found him on, he had a, on one of his pages, he had a Twitter, a link to his Twitter. So I went on his Twitter and I just DM'd him and I was like, thanks so much. Like, I told him it was a nice surprise to wake up and see the async pieces sold. Thanks very much. And he said, hey, great to talk with you. I'm a huge fan. Finding the pieces was a surprise to me. And I asked him what, it's like he hadn't heard about this NFT. And that's kind of the case with some of these, like the NFT world is growing so rapidly and it's actually so small that people hear about it, but there's the amount of people who are actually involved is not very big. So he found the, I mean, there's a huge rush on NFTs right now. It's like, you know, it's getting crazy again. And the layers, he bought all the layers and the master track, so he now can completely singularly control the whole thing. He said, I said, what are you going to do with the combinations of layers? You can control the fans' experience with that song now. And he said, yeah, crazy thinking about it. I'm going to change the layers every 2 to 3 weeks. So you guys know he's going to change the layers every 2 to 3 weeks and probably give a heads up on his Twitter before that, just to the hardcore follower. So if you like this track and you want to follow what happens with it, then you can follow Matt. I think it's M4T. Let me just double check. M4T underscore NFT. So Matt is obviously super deep in the game. I think Matt is actually involved in Flamingo, which is, I believe, a DAO. He's involved in the space. Anyway, so that is cool. For you guys who, you know, I know you got a lot of people are like, oh, you know, what about it's so expensive and blah, blah, blah. Yes. So they are expensive, but what I'm looking for in this space actually right now is like finding ways to offer things that are not so expensive. So this is the equivalent of buying like an original painting at an art show, right? Though the prices of original painting in an art show is very high, but then if you buy a print or if you buy a t-shirt or sticker, blah, 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 like that's very affordable. And that's something that most of you guys can get. The only hurdle in front of that for you is that you got to learn how to get, basically you have to get an account, to convert your money into crypto. And then you have to get a wallet. So I recommend just getting, if you're in the US, just get a Coinbase account. And for the wallet, get a MetaMask wallet. And once you have those two things, you can buy NFTs. Done. You're done. And you might say, oh, why would I do that? Well, if you understand buying a skin in a video game or buying an add-on to like your something digital like that. Like if you play any games at all and you buy a skin in a game, this is like, think of it that way, because it's really like, what's nice about this is it's not locked into any game or whatever. It's on it. You can use it however you want. In the case of some NFTs, not this one, but some NFTs that give you a bunch of rights too. So just last word on this. Matt is going to change this mix every 2 to 3 weeks, he said. Right now it sounds like this. If you want to purchase an NFT recording of this, then you could just go on this page. So just go to, you know, async.art and search me, and you'll find this. And then when you go down below, you'll see all the different tiers of NFTs of recordings. So each of these is like, this is a 1 of 10. When the 10 are gone, it's over. 1 of 2,000, 1 of 2,000. So these guys are less expensive. And that's an actual NFT of the recording of the song in its current state. So when he changes it, he's going to change it, and then it's going to be different, and you won't get this one. He might never come back to this one. I don't know. It's all in Matt's control. So yeah, I thought that's fun. I thought that's different. Like, you don't have, you know, that's not something that's like, that we do all the time, right? Actually, we have like a price on this guy right now to bid on a silver edition. History? Anyway. All right. So cool. That's what I have to say about that for today. Somebody said, don't spend it all on CryptoKitties. I mean, I feel like if you own a CryptoKitty, that's kind of like, I don't hate on any of that. I think it's kind of awesome to have like a CryptoKitty in your wallet. It's like a little piece of crypto history. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, in 5-10 years, are you going to be like, when CryptoKitties are more expensive than they are now, you might be saying like, damn, I kind of wish I had bought a CryptoKitty. I don't have a CryptoKitty. I actually, currently, my current philosophy is that the money that I make in the NFT space, I'm gonna probably buy NFTs with it currently. I made some crypto, and I'm saving the crypto. So that's like putting it in the savings account. And now that I've done a little bit of that, now I wanna collect a few things. So I'm gonna collect. But I'm not collecting like, you know, like Steve Aoki's collecting on he's hysterical. Like there are people that's obviously spending millions and millions of dollars on NFTs. Because they believe in this space and they want to support the community and they think they're going to make money. All of those things. I shouldn't even say think. They are already making a lot of money. But, you know, you could buy something and make a big mistake and be stuck with it and not make any money. Or you could, you know, other things can happen, whatever. Yes. Okay. So good. We done with that? You want to talk about it anymore? Or are we moving on? Moving on to a raid. Are NFTs resellable? Absolutely. Go on OpenSea. OpenSea is like one of the biggest, NFT trading hubs. It's probably the biggest. You can find everything on OpenSea. OpenSea.com. What is it? .io. .io. Yeah. OpenSea.io. And you can find everything on there. Like, that's another thing that's cool like this is even though mine was minted, mine was like, minted means like it was like published with async art. It's available on OpenSea. OpenSea is like the Google of NFTs. So you can go on there and see any NFT that anybody's bought, really. Yeah. So you can see, and you can literally like look in like Stevie Aoki's wallet if you want. I probably shouldn't say that, but you can. You can see all the crazy shit that he's bought. And all these other people. Like it's pretty cool. I do think of it as like skins in video games though. Cause it's not exclusive to rich people. It's not. Like you could if you made one of you could make NFTs and sell them for, you know, $50. And other people in this chat could buy them for $50 and use them, like put them on your Twitter for your, you know, profile picture on social media, or just, you know, just show them. You can showcase them on like your TV and stuff like that. Like they have apps for, Async actually makes a great app for putting your NFTs on your TV screen. You can buy frames for them, like, and just import them into the frame and it'll sit on a frame on your desk, like a little digital frame. And do you do that with your friend's artwork? Like I could make, you could make them, anybody could make them and just give them away too. I mean, that'll cost the person who made them money, but it is what it is. Yeah. And by the way, it's not like, I mean, you could, you know, if you make them, it could be like you could make a bunch and spend money doing it and then nobody could buy them. It's the same thing as like anything, right? Like if you make paintings, think of it like if you made a bunch of paintings and did an art show, you could do that. And then people could be like, oh, like, good job, friend. And like, no. I think gas prices right now are actually pretty good. I mean, compared to what they were months ago, the technology is getting better. Oh, and you can do it. Is Moon here in the chat? Moon's been deep in the space. Because the technology has improved. Moon, did you end up doing did you end up doing non-Ethereum NFTs? Gas is $2.98. That's awesome. I was, dude, when I got into it, gas that month was like $150. Yeah, Moon's not using Ethereum anymore. There's other ways to mint. You can mint them. You could go more. I mean, you could go look for a much more. You could look for a. What do I want to call it? Like a format of creating and gamifying and selling your work that fits your philosophy. Yeah. You could do it. Yeah. Steve Harry bought with 20 Ethereum? More like 200. He's bought, no. They've, dude, I think he bought one for like 100 and something. Like it's, yeah. Anyway, yeah. Anyone who's interested, you know, go do your homework. I'm not going to talk about it anymore today. Thank you guys very much for watching. We're going to do a raid. We have a new raid. Let's see if this one's up. New raid. Oh, not on today. All right. So we're back to this move. Looking at all the raids that we're not gonna be able to. Looking at all the names we're not gonna be able to raid. All right. Oh, shit. Alexander Early, stream starting soon. There you go. Lao Riva redeemed a raid of Alexander Early, who is now supposedly about to start streaming. Shout out. We're gonna raid. All right, guys. Please enjoy. I will not be on Thursday, and on Friday we're gonna do a Bowl of Destiny. All right. Thanks for watching. I'll see you later. Bye.